During instruction time, you may want to limit what websites your students have access to. For example, in a previous video, we mentioned sending a YouTube video to students as a hook in your lesson. You want students to be able to access the YouTube video, but not all of YouTube. Web rules will allow this and much more in your class. To apply web rules to your classes, you'll need to navigate to web rules. You'll find this next to your pause internet toggle. Once on this page, you will see the choices, allow lists and block lists. If no rules are applied, web rules are set to off. Off means that students will be able to browse all sites permitted by your school district. Allow means students can only visit websites you list. Allow is the most restrictive set of lists you can use. It is important to note that you will not be able to allow sites that are blocked by your district filter. Block means your students can browse all websites except those you add to the block list. It is less restrictive than allow. Let's look at allow mode. Allow is a great tool for keeping students on sites that are subject specific. When you select allow lists, you will see an area where you can create up to 20 allow lists. To create an allow list, click the plus button on new allow list. Click the pencil next to new list, name the list. Click the shield with the check mark to select a color for the list. Click into the box to add in your website URLs. You can add one website per line with a max of 100 websites per list. Once you have added your websites to your list, click Update List. Hover over the list or list that you would like to use during your class periods. Choose Select List. Your allow lists will be available in all of your other classes that are rostered to you as well. You can create lists for every class that you teach. For example, if you teach a math class and a science class, you can create separate lists for each class and you can access those lists in any class that you are in. If you teach with a co-teacher, you will be able to view and apply web rule lists from your co-teacher. Note that lists can only be applied from one source at a time. You can use your list or the co-teacher's list, but not both at the same time. To allow internet access to your students once they have completed their work, you will need to expand the advanced options drop-down. Check the box next to full internet access when done. If you use an SSO solution such as Clever or Google, you will need to check the box next to allow single sign-on so that your students will be able to go directly to the sites that use SSO. Once you have selected your lists and your advanced options, click Apply Lists. Please note, wildcards cannot be used in allow or block lists. When creating allow lists, be sure to include any redirects from other websites. For example, the website Kahoot.com redirects to Kahoot.it. Be sure to include both sites in your allow list to ensure your students do not get a blocked page message. Now let's look at block mode. Maybe it's a no YouTube kind of day. You can make a no YouTube list. Much like the allow section, you will see an area where you can create up to 20 block lists. Create your lists, select the lists you would like to use, and click Apply List to enable your selections. To turn off web rules, click the Allow or Block Mode button next to the Pause Internet button. Click on Turn Off Web Rules. To edit a list, click View List. Click Add Website URL. Add a new URL or delete a URL. Click Update List. To delete a list, click View List. Click the trash can in the upper right-hand corner. Verify that you want to delete the list by clicking Yes, I want to delete my list. Use web rules in the same way with any group segments that you have created. We will discuss managing student groups in another video. You're now ready to use web rules to manage websites your students can access. Thank you for joining us.